Hello, I'm Iti. Welcome to my channel, where we do everything together. Let's take a look at some Afrikaans words that might be much more difficult for foreign language speakers to pronounce. Some of these words are pretty long, and others have a lot of ch sounds. Onvergevensgesindheid. Onvergevensgesindheid. That's an unforgiving attitude, which means this person just doesn't want to forgive you or just doesn't forgive people in general. Volledigheidshalve. Volledigheidshalve. For the sake of completeness. Toerekeningsvatbaarheid. Toerekeningsvatbaarheid. And that means culpability. Here we have two words that are very much related. The first one, rochel. Rochel. And that means gurgle. That's more the sound you make when you gargle with something. And then we have gorrel, gorrel, which is gargle. And that's when you gargle with a substance. Maybe your throat is hurting and you're gargling with salt. And that's gorrel. Geginnegaap, geginnegaap. That is the past tense of ginnegaap. Just a little bit more difficult to pronounce. And so ginnegaap means to chat jokingly, to mess around or talk with your friends jokingly, not at all serious. And then the teacher in the class would tell you, hou op ginnegaap and do your work. Hou op ginnegaap en doen jou werk. Geregenereer, geregenereer. That is the past tense of regenereer. Regenereer means regenerate, and regenereer is the past tense, which is regenerated. Geslachtsgemeenskap. Geslachtsgemeenskap. And that is sexual intercourse. So that is just the more fancy word for sex. Bochelruggie. Bochelruggie. That is the diminutive word for bochelrug. And that is the word used for a hump on the back, so a humpback, or for a hunchback. Gamma globulin. Gamma globulin. That is gamma globulin, and it plays a role in your immune system. Besienswaardigheid. Besienswaardigheid. That is simply a sight worth seeing. So when you go to Paris and you look at the Eiffel Tower, you would call the Eiffel Tower a besienswaardigheid. This word is not a difficult to pronounce word. And these are also four separate words. However, we pronounce them as one in Afrikaans. And it also encompasses one thing. So this is very important to learn because we use it almost daily. It is the Afrikaans words for obvious. So we say, voor die hand liggend, voor die hand liggend. You pronounce this as one. And so you would tell somebody, it is voor die hand liggend, which means it is obvious. Glibberigheid. Glibberigheid. Slipperiness. Genuchtig. Genuchtig. And that is something like good gracious. This is also important to learn. This is another thing that we use often. Another exclamation that we use often in Afrikaans. Genuchtig. So you'll say this in surprise or astonishment. Genuchtig. And just because, coaguleermiddel. Coaguleermiddel. And that is coagulant. Geïnteresseerd. Geïnteresseerd. And that means to be interested in something or someone. The base word there is interessant. Geïrriteerd. Geïrriteerd. To be irritated by something or someone. Registrateurskantoor. Registrateurskantoor. That is the registrar's office. Samehorigheidsgevoel. Samehorigheidsgevoel. A feeling of solidarity. And lastly, suggereerbaar. Suggereerbaar. And that is suggestible.